this video, we are going to share one of the interview questions that was encountered by one of our subscriber friends. So he has asked us for the solution. So we have provided the solution. So thought of making the video, and it might help few others as well. So the question goes like this. So there is a array of strings. So inside that string, we have one, then the subject name and the marks secured in the subject, then two, the subject name, then there is marks, then three, subject name and marks, and the output should be that we need to calculate the average marks, like English in the, there are two Englishes here, so English we got 45 45, so the average would be 45, and Hindi there is only one, has only, then the average would be 60. So we have given the solution as well for this. So we would copy paste the same solution. I'll explain the logic. So firstly, we will be creating one result map, which is of string and list of integers. Then this is the input that we got from our subscriber friend, and we have added one more element to the array. We can add one more here. So copy. So I'll be using some subject. Okay. Comma. So let us make it 5. Maths, let's take it as maths. Okay, so this is the input, guys. So basically this question is on, basically this would be asked for any Java developer who is having an interview experience range of 2 to like 4 plus, because this mainly shows like how good you are with the arrays, how you can manipulate with arrays, like with the given input array or with the array or with the string, like how you can manipulate a string as well. Both things, or you will be judged on like your experience on arrays as well as on the string. So let us see. Using the first, I'll be using a for loop with the length of the input array. Then what I'll do, I'll find the index of hyphen. This is the hyphen. So ideally we need this part of the string from the array. So for each element we need this part. So I'll be getting the index of that. Then I'll be using the string substring method. And now here in this sub and marks substring, we'll be having this part of the string, English colon 45. What I'll do, I'll split the array using the colon, and it will return a subject and marks array, like English will be on the 0th element and 45 would be on the first element. Okay, so now what I'll do, I'll have an if condition whether the result contains already the subject name, like the key is already present or not. If it is already present, what I'll do, I'll get the value of it, which is list, and I'll add the new value into it. So list will be having one more element of this marks. If at all that is not present, what I'll do, I'll directly create one new list, add the value into that list, and I'll add that into the map. So this is the way we do. So the output would be like, the key would be the subject, like English, and there are two English, so English would be the key, and the list of marks, like 45 and 45 would be in the list. Similarly for Hindi, like 60 and 90 would be there, and for the maths, only one key and only one value in the list, that would be 90. And what I am doing, I am using Java 8 for loop for each, and I'm finding out the average using average method, and I am printing out that result. So let us run this and see the output, whether we are getting the desired output or not. Okay, I haven't saved. Let us save and see. Here is the output. So for the maths, there is only one subject, so average is 90. For English, there are two, so that is the average is 45. For Hindi, the average is 75. So we can check cross verify as well. So 45 plus 45, 90 by 2, 45. Hindi 60 plus 90. 150, average is 75. Math, as there is only one element, the average is 90. So this is the output, guys. This is the logic. I'll be pinging the logic in the comment section as well. If you want, you can go through it. So ideally this shows how good you are in strings as well as on arrays. So do practice these kind of questions. I basically on splitting of arrays and finding the substrings. Okay, I hope this video helps you. And if you have faced any similar kind of questions, and if you are unable to find out the solution for that, you can ping us. we'll try to give our best solution. We'll try to give the best approach for that. Thanks for watching and all the best for your interview preparation.